Hello, I am Jody Wolf, and you're watching Exposed, June 5, 2013, 11:43 p.m. Birmingham, Alabama. Topic: Where is your heart? What I want to tell you about is the parallel between Noah in his day and Lot in his day. Go back, and the reason Noah's day was as it was, the angels that left their first estate, in other words, the ones that followed Satan, fell. In heaven, angels cannot procreate. On earth, the fallen angels could, and they did. And not only did they procreate with the daughters of men, they procreated with everything that they could get their hands on. And I'm being literal about that. Animals. Fish. Fish with birds. Humans with fish. Folks, there were mermaids. You name it, they put it together and created it. That was in the days of Noah. God chose Noah out of Noah's grace, or rather out of God's grace. Noah was not necessarily good or deserving, rather merely a just man. He was perfect in his generations. He was untainted by the polluted bloodline of the angelic intermarriage. Since Scripture doesn't say such angelic intermarriage takes place in the last days, most people see Jesus' comment about Noah as prefiguring the rapture. That's true, but there's a lot more than just that. Genesis 6 describes the most direct and unfettered contact between human beings in general than the spirit world recorded in the entire Bible, apart from those recorded in Revelations during the tribulation period. That's why Jesus said, as in the days of Noah, those days will come again. And then you fast forward from there and go to Lot. Lot, in his day, it was the same. There was continually these still the offspring from the sons of God, the fallen angels that had sex with the daughters of men, were still here. And Sodom and Gomorrah were completely covered in these things. Their thoughts was always in one place. It was never good. Think about this. It can be argued that the television is an imagination in a box. Then we vicariously live out our dreams and fantasies through that television, okay? Somewhere on the cable dial there's something for the imagination of everyone's heart. So look at what is the imagination of your thought? Or our thoughts of this generation. Their heart thinks of porno, slasher movies, Madonna, Britney Spears, demon movies, movies about Satan. That's the imagination of our hearts continually every day. This is why we are winding down to an end. God caused the flood to get rid of those, but then also God says that they were in the earth in those days and after they remained. Now again, it doesn't mean that they're going to come down here and start this over. I don't know. No one knows. But God says, in these days, in our end days, it will be worse than it was in the days of Noah. He said, there's never been a time like that, nor will there ever be a time this bad again. Those words, this bad again. It's coming. Our hearts today, think again about what you watch on television. They didn't have television back then, but they acted out their fantasies back then. And they did it, and all the things they did was an abomination to God. They took everything God created and twisted it, mangled it, put it together, and came out with something horrible. The angels that took fish and human DNA mixed them. You think mermaids are beautiful, gorgeous women? They were hideous creatures. You think they take you take the Tyrannosaurus, not the Tyrannosaurus Rex, and the dinosaur. They probably mix the dinosaur with an alligator, and you got a Tyrannosaurus Rex, a mouth as big as his whole body. God didn't create those things. He created green grass eating giants called dinosaurs. Anyway, I've gone beyond where I wanted to go, and but it's the corruption of the human race was the main reason for the flood, and the corruption for the human race is the main reason for the end times to occur again in the tribulation. You gotta escape it. You can't escape it. Simple. John 3:16. If you don't escape it, you just don't know what's coming your way. Jody Wolf, expose.